little Lou doing?
No response.
Well, look at that. The child's taking a shine to me. You two were out cold, so I had you brought here. You were right. Whatever you did back there returned us to our own world. I put your cargo and gear in your private box. You slept for a whole day, you know. Slept like the dead. I'm already back in Capital Knot. Fragile's beach has been coming in handy. Sam, I owe you an apology. Lou was the name you were going to give your own baby if he'd had made it. I should have pieced it together sooner.
Don't know what you're talking about.
I found some records from 10 years ago. A death, sudden, in the middle of a town. Young woman in the prime of her life. Nobody knew until it was too late. A void out. Her husband, who was a member of Bridges, had dooms. He tried, but he couldn't get to her in time. The whole town was wiped off the map, leaving nothing but a big crater and him. Because he was a repatriate. People wanted answers. Did the man hide his wife's body on purpose? The only survivor was the only suspect. He was easy to blame, and people did. And pretty soon, they were blaming Bridges too. The man felt responsible, so he left. And his wife, who died, her name was Lucy. She'd been pregnant, poor woman. They were going to name their son, Lou.
Didn't happen.
But it did. President Strand told me. She talked about you all the time. He didn't have to cut all ties and walk away, she said.
You wanna shut the fuck up?
Calm down, Sam. Take a seat. I told you before about my body. 70% harvested from cadavers. Do you want to know the real reason why? Because the story you've heard is one I made up. The truth is, I'm Frankenstein's monster. Artificial, grown from pluripotent stem cells. And when that vital spark didn't manifest in all my organs, they replaced the defective ones with those of the dead. I never had a birthday. I'm a soulless meat puppet. No ka, a dead man. People born the traditional way have beaches. You have one. BB too. But I have no such connections. No mother. No afterlife. No beach. You see now why I'm so obsessed with it all? Why I joined Bridges? The battlefield. Now that was an awful beach. But strangely, I didn't hate it. Because I knew you were coming for me. I've never felt that before. Connected to someone, anyone. You didn't have to cut all ties and walk away. The president was right about that much.
It wasn't anything to walk away from. It's not like I was ever welcome there.
Come on, even I was welcome. Oh, that. You were holding it. It's an old dog tag, US issue. Wasn't easy prying it out of your hand. Clifford Unger, as you can see. I looked him up in our database. Found a match. He was US Army Special Forces. Fought in Kosovo, Iraq, Afghanistan.
That's him.
Well, that's all I've managed to dig up so far. You must be caked in chiral matter from the battlefield. Time for a shower, I'd say. Oh, I won't be joining you this time. The Die Hardman issue is no longer a concern. I've seen to it that our conversations won't be recorded.
Sam, do you copy? As you might have suspected, time here stopped while you two were on that battlefield.
If my thinking is correct, the dimension to which you traveled is a kind of beach. To explain a little, our bodies, our ha, all occupy the same world, but our souls, our ka, have beaches all their own. These beaches are given form inside our brains by our beliefs, religion, philosophy, and so forth. As a result, a beach can be anything, and those anythings form a multiverse. However, if many people die at once, their beaches can become entangled, creating a strand field. This phenomenon is exacerbated in wartime by omnipresent feelings of resentment and despair. Beaches are more easily and frequently entangled. On such a beach, exits vanish and experiences cycle endlessly. Picture it like a record player. The needle skips, playing the same phrase again and again. They're fighting a battle that has no beginning or end. Round and round it goes. Now, the battlefield you visited was in Eastern Europe in World War II. Which is strange, given that the man you encountered, Clifford Unger, played no part in that conflict. I can't explain it, but if you can connect me to the chiral network, who knows what we might discover.
Still there, Sam? If so, I have a request. When you're ready, head upstairs to the delivery terminal.
ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Fortune.
Sam, the west side of that region is covered by a massive tar belt. Beyond it is Edgenot City, the last bastion of civilization you'll find that far out. It's your final destination. Once you use the Cupid to connect it, the Chiral network will span the entire continent. The rebirth of America is so close. And remember, that's where Amelie is being held captive. We need you to bring her home safely. But before you cross the tar belt, there's one more knot we need you to tie. Hartman will help you get it done.
Sam, I'd like for you to bring me a few things. First, the dog tags you took from that soldier. Tuck them away in a pocket so you don't misplace them. Second, Mama's corpse. Her body shows no signs of necrosis, and I, for one, would like very much to know the reason why. Closer study may yield information that could prove instrumental in helping us to overcome the Death Stranding. Suffice it to say,
1 minute remaining.
I don't have much time. See to your preparations. I'll be waiting. You'll find an official order on the terminal.
on keeping on.
Thank you so much.
Gotcha.
Drop by whatever you like.
Thanks for the help. This one's for you. Thanks for the help.
Weapons restrictions lifted. Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges. Restrictions lifted.
and the other.
Hello! Thank you.
Construction complete.
City wouldn't be on the chiral network if it weren't for you. And now we can finally do our part for the UCA. Sorry you had to go through so much trouble. Just know that we appreciate it. Wow, you really took great care of everything. I mean, honestly, you'd be hard-pressed to call this anything less than perfect. Since joining the UCA, we've been able to communicate with people all over. We've learned a lot from them, and them from us, I'd like to think. We've never felt so connected. You know, folks have shared stories about you too. You know, the incredible things you've done. I gotta be honest, part of me still can't believe you're real. Much less that you're willing to go through hell and back just to keep us going. That, anyway, sorry. You got places to be. Just know that you'll always be welcome here. Why don't you rest up before you go?
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
morning, Sam. Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
Bo.